In 2015, an extremely odd website with the domain name of WorldCorpo.net surfaced online. The website, presented as WorldCorpo Enterprises respectively, was rather bare bones in nature. In addition to links to a YouTube channel, a SoundCloud page, and a Discord server, three sections of the site were heavily featured on the homepage. Images, which led to a collection of what I can best describe as weird quorum vaporwave aesthetic type edits, music featuring a ton of audio files containing rap music created presumably by WorldCorp Enterprises themselves, and most notoriously, videos, which contained a slew of very bizarre and disturbing videos, most if not all of which I advise not looking at yourself. The website went largely unnoticed for a long period of time, gaining very little attention outside of various 4chan threads that would go from time to time. In 2019, YouTuber Scare Theater uploaded his video, Weird YouTube Videos Episode 7. In it, he discussed a video sent to him from an anonymous email entitled, Dreamer Heaven, Levels 1, Demise of Reptile. The video was sent with no prior information or background, and any replies to the initial email were ignored. Shortly after being featured in the video, Mudahar of Some Ordinary Gamer submitted a video strongly advising Scare Theater to take his video down, as Dreamer Heaven Levels 1 Demise of Reptile was a video with a far more disturbing background than what Scare Theater knew at the time. The video itself is what seems to be heavily tampered with and distorted, but still extremely disturbing and sickening footage of real-life child abuse, with some going as far to say the video is taken from a full-on CP video found in the deep web. As far as we know, this extremely disturbing video's origins in the clear web is WorldCorp's website, leading many to believe they themselves created it. This created a huge resurgence of investigation after its initial creation in 2015, with most coming to the conclusion that WorldCorp as a whole was some sort of elaborate dark web cult. Now, let's just get this out of the way first and foremost. WorldCorp is not a cult, it's not a pedo ring, in fact it's probably one of the most unremarkable internet mini-phenomenons of the last decade. Researching this video, I've probably heard every single theory you can possibly come up with regarding this whole ordeal, and they all seem to put a shit ton of stock into the idea WorldCorp was some sort of deep web death cult, and not the much more reasonable and possible explanation that this is just some edgelord shitty web art project, which, you know, should be fucking obvious at this point. The main general theory also seems to be that the man in the video's voice sounds similar to that of John Podesta, which has caused an immense overlap from WorldCorp into the whole Pizzagate scandal thing, when in reality they have literally nothing to do with each other. I think my favorite theory this has spawned is that the dude rapping in the WorldCorp music sounds like John Podesta, which not only implies somehow that he let all these fucked up child abuse videos leak at the height of his scandal, but he also made a bunch of rap songs at one point or another which also leaked, which all in all just sounds like an idea that would be passed around as a joke in the fucking InfoWars writing room. Like, this fucking man right here. This theory in particular is ironic, as most channels and theories that cover WorldCorp seem to glance over the music as a whole, despite the fact looking at it for any amount of time will lend a large amount of credence to the idea that WorldCorp is less of a weird deep web sex ring, and more of a bunch of edgy 4chan kids' weird Mad Villain influenced music project. The music on WorldCorp's site and SoundCloud is actually very well made and decent, and isn't what you'd expect from what most people assume to either be a cult or a shitty ARG, and it's not as extreme as, say, that one deep web album made entirely out of CP samples. I've never really seen anyone look at the WorldCorp music in any sort of actual detail on YouTube before, which is a shame, because not only does it completely debunk the idea that WorldCorp is a spooky fucking cult, but the music itself they put out is also very underappreciated in of itself. So I guess I'll just take some time to look at it myself, yeah. Okay, so contrary to what you'll find online, there is no official WorldCorp album or mixtape, and the ones you can find online are more like compilations of music made available through their website or SoundCloud. The one that's most complete, quote-unquote, is the Basement mixtape, so it's the one I'll be looking at today. Now allow me to channel my inner Anthony Fantano as I deliver a deadpan, uninteresting review of this album. Oh, shit. Okay, so from the start, this album is at the very least an extremely interesting listen, even if only based on intrigue due to the background and general mystery surrounding it. Most of these songs were recorded in 2016 and 17, with the very last song being uploaded in February of 2018. The production and sound on this mixtape, and all of WorldCorp's music, has a very nice, dirty, and murky boom-bap sound to it. As I alluded to earlier, all of their music sounds like it's heavily influenced by MF Doom / Mad Villain, which is especially obvious on a relatively obscure track called Bootleg 2A, which isn't on this mixtape, but uses the instrumental track Supervillain Theme as the instrumental, so the influences are pretty clear on all their music. It kinda sounds like he made a whole bunch of those free MF Doom, x Madlib, x Freddie Gibbs, x Boom Bap, Jazz Rap, Old School Instrumental type beat, production, Little Shit Stain, Untagged beats that are all over YouTube, but like, put them through a whole bunch of distortion and turn the export quality down a bunch. I know that probably sounds like an insult, but the actual product itself sounds very nice and well put together. The vocals sound like they were recorded in Audacity by a 15-year-old kid in his closet trying not to wake his mom up, which fits with a lot of the lyrical content of either being a deadbeat in his 40s or an average 4chan user. But it also has the jarring quality where you can't tell if it's multiple guys in all these songs or just one guy rapping in different styles and inflections. The overall lyrical content mostly consists of either being a cool CEO boss man, hating your wife and kids, or hating yourself and being a neckbeard basement dwelling loser. Like me. I've actually seen people try to use the World Corp lyrics to fuel this whole Podesta CP conspiracy thing, but like, it's the biggest reach you can possibly come up with since half these lyrics are just meme shit anyway. And on the topic of meme shit, if this came out now, it most likely would have blended in precisely with both the insufferably inescapable Sigma Male and Discord mod / Redditor memes, which seem to have only increased since 2017 and now refuse to die regardless of how tired they become. Yet, this has somehow not managed to influence my enjoyment of this album, despite anything remotely connected to overused shitty Reddit memes being automatically horseshit to me. But yeah, they're all really solid tracks, and if you enjoy boom bap, or even just weird late 2000s 4chan influenced meme type shit, I'd recommend listening to Basement Mixtape. Even though it's unofficial, it's still surprisingly well done for what most people consider to be some weird deep web shit. I don't actually have anything else to say about their music, so I'm just gonna take the lazy route and make a tier list of all their songs, because I need more fucking filler!
Let's turn his brightness up a little bit. Damn,
okay, so let's make a world... Oh wait, shit, is there actually already a World Corp tier list? Let me see. Oh shit, there actually already is a World Corp tier list. Okay, so I'm gonna start by putting High Stakes in A, because I'm a contrarian. And if it's popular, that means it's overrated and or bad, so fuck you. Okay, I'm gonna put Cease and Desist right here, because that's a pretty okay song. I'm gonna put Gamble in S tier, because goddamn, is that a fucking hot beat, though. That's like... I have absolute jack shit to say about most of these songs, so this is probably the least interesting tier list of all time. Business Day is pretty okay. I don't know what I'm quite looking at in most of these things, because it's so purple, so I don't really know what I'm looking at most of the time. I don't have really any interesting commentary to put over this. I'm beginning to think this whole video was like a massive mistake. It's... fuck. Yeah, that's the song, I think. Okay, I'm pretty sure this is every track on the Basement Mixtape. I can't really identify most of these because, like, information regarding which is associated with which track is, you know, it's kind of scarce, so this is the best I can do. This is my official tier list of the World Corp Basement Mixtape tracks. If anyone wants to debate about this, they can do that in the comments. Yeah.
Okay, so I don't really have anything else to say about this album. I don't really think going into a track-by-track breakdown would be too interesting. So I guess with that, I give Basement Mixtape by World Corp Enterprises a light 6 out of 10. Fuck you. So the question most are probably asking now is, who was World Corp exactly?
Not fucking John Podesta, that's for sure.
The thing is, nobody actually knows who World Corp even was for sure, or what they were thinking using all this weird shit on their website. Depending on who you ask, the child abuse videos are very, very real, but World Corp themselves didn't create them. There's another video on their site featuring a pretty well-known live leak video of a girl being run over, so by that logic, World Corp was also responsible for that, despite that obviously being untrue. However, there's been a lot of evidence put out recently to support the fact that they were definitely made by World Corp, but it's less like Child and Predator and more like older brother terrorizing younger brother. Regardless of what you think, though, really all signs point to World Corp just being an edgy music project, and nothing more, nothing less. However, there is a lead as to who World Corp could possibly be, although it's not really confirmed. The rap group Autistic Boys Money Clan have long been suspected to be the ones behind World Corp for a while, and there are a lot of leads to suggest they have the same people behind them. I don't want to say for sure yet, but I also demand everybody watching this to not go flooding ABMC's DMs or comments asking about World Corp. At this point, the drama is something that needs to stay in the past, and it has enough conclusive evidence to the point really little if anything more needs to be done. If anything, just go support their music if you like World Corp. It's not exactly the same style, but they make extremely high quality shit. So yeah, that's a basic rundown of World Corp and a look into their music. There are still a lot of details I didn't go into for time's sake, but despite my bashing, there are a couple of really well-made World Corp videos on YouTube that go over what I left out pretty well. So yeah, join my Discord, Twitter, and I'm out. Peace.
Oh, Jesus fucking Christ.
So yeah, sorry for uploading so fucking late. You know, I've just been dealing with a lot of IRL shit lately, you know, lack of motivation, etc. You know, but I in 2022 I have some decent enough video ideas, I guess, that I'm well motivated to do, so I guess expect, you know, more uploads frequently this year. I don't fucking know. Yeah.